Every day, the RNLI's volunteer crews rescue 20 people from the sea around our coasts. But as a charity, we rely on donations. That's why we need people like you to call 0800 543 210 and pledge £3 a month. For people in trouble at sea, we're literally a lifeline. So please ring 0800 543 210 and pledge £3 a month. Because if you don't, who will?
The RNLI have been an established emergency service since 1824 and have been patrolling 140 beaches and shores to date. The RNLI have saved over 137,000 lives at sea since 1824. They have also lost around 800 people since then. We spoke to Mike Buckland, a helmsman of the RNLI at Western Supermare Lifeboat Station. We wanted to find out his views. We also spoke to Pete Holden, the Lifeboat Operation Manager at Western Supermare.
I've lived in Western most of my life, and so having always seen as a small child the lifeboat station out here on Birnbeck Island, it was always something I was slightly fascinated with. I remember as a Cub Scout coming out here as a little boy and having a look round and dressing up in all the kit that you see here behind me. I don't know, there's always just been this sort of boyhood fascination, I suppose, and when I moved away to university and then came back here to live, I decided that then was the time to sort of find out how I could go about joining up. And so I did. I talked to Pete, our boss, it was offered the opportunity about 10 or 12 years ago to join up, and I haven't looked back since, really.
Yes, indeed. Quite often, people will either write to us a letter of thanks or they will telephone and sort of say how much they appreciated what was done for them.
We have family members, we have the people themselves who have come down in the past, who have, you know, come down, taken us out for a drink, bought us a beer, sent us a card or a letter, and, you know, not that we expect that or we hang out for that, but of course it makes a huge difference. It's really quite touching when somebody does make that call or make that phone call or come in and say thank you.
We ask the public for their views and opinions of the RNLI's funding and importance.
Yes, definitely.
Yes, of course. Because they're doing a job to assist other people, like the fire brigade and the police, etc. When in jeopardy.
Of course, yeah, they are an emergency service, aren't they?
Yes.
Who else is going to save people out on the sea?
Most definitely. We are the only marine rescue service in the United Kingdom and Ireland. We are the main one. We're coordinated, yes, by a government department, which is the HM Coast Guard, or the MCA as it's known nowadays, but there really is no other marine rescue service which operates the boats like we do all the way around the coast. There are a small number of private rescue boats, but certainly not on the same standard of logistical backup that the RNLI endures. And if you think that we undertake to have a lifeboat up to 100 miles offshore in any weather, at the answer to a pager, I think that's a pretty fine achievement, really.
Am I happy with where we're based? Well, the base we've got here on Birnbeck Island is the best base we could ever have. However, as everybody who lives in Western knows, the state of the pier and the state of the island is not what we'd like it to be. We've been over the years looking at different people who've owned the pier, had plans for it, they've fallen through for whatever reason. And clearly, as time goes on, everything becomes even worse in terms of its state of repair. So am I happy? I'd love to stay here. We'd love to keep the base here. Will it happen? Who knows? The RNLI is always looking at opportunities and plans for the future, but the best place for us to be is here, and that's why the lifeboat station was sited here in the first place.
Good morning from the West today.
The RNLI have recently hit the TV, appearing on the ITV News regarding the health and safety of Birnbeck Pier.
RNLI in Western Supermare is currently operating from two temporary sites, one on the River Axe and one on Birnbeck's crumbling pier. Rescuers say the situation is far from ideal, and it's taking longer to reach people in.
So we've got really, really strong tides here in Weston, and we've had extremely bad weather yesterday. So what's happened is, as you can see up along the side of the slipway here, we've got huge boulders which are there to protect the smaller stones. But actually with the strong tides and the strong winds, they've got pushed off the top of the pile of boulders and are now blocking our slipway. So what we're having to do is get use the tractor and the cable to actually drag the big boulders clear to make sure that we've then got a safe slipway to bring both the lifeboats down should we need to.
Yes, because they help to protect the community.
Because we're paying enough taxes already, so let the government pop it out.
Yes, well, they need all the money they can get.
I suppose it should really, because ambulances and things like that
are
also.
I reckon that would be. Well, they save people's lives, so it's obviously a good idea that people fund that.